I was making emphasis to the issue of being within 5K. One would have thought that 5K, 10K, 20K wouldn't make a blind bit of difference, and it would allow people to have a better environment to choose from as they spend their leisure time. Certainly, it would mean that places where they're crowded at the weekends wouldn't be as crowded because of the 5K. And I was wondering if anybody had put any petitions together. And on that, I got some phone calls. Amongst them was from Sinead. Sinead, good morning.
Hey Neil, how are things?
So you heard that and you wanted to fill me in. What have you been doing?
Well, I suppose, you know, I mean, to give a bit of context, I'm 34. So a lot of, I suppose, my age group, you know, we'd be in an age where maybe we're not going out all the time, but of course, to like socializing and things like that and exercising and everything. And just 5 kilometers is obviously, you know, not great for anyone, but yeah. Like, I started, because people were all complaining, me included, and I started a petition, and I was saying to Emer yesterday, like, I got, like, 4 signatures, you know? And, like, as someone who has probably 650 friends on Facebook, or acquaintances on Facebook, you know, to look at that and get 4 signatures, it kind of just, it's kind of like what we've been doing all of these lockdowns, just complaining and doing nothing.
So you put the petition together up on change.org. You certainly asked those people who share your Facebook platform to go and sign it digitally, and they didn't.
Yeah, and I suppose I was saying to someone, I was like, it was kind of more a social experiment, you know?
Why do you think they didn't?
You know, there's a funny thing, because everybody's kind of almost, I think, afraid to go against what we're being told, and I'm not going against our 5 kilometers, like I'm certainly not, but you know, we have to be, you know, it's like we're happy not being informed of everything and just going along with everything. So then if we go against what we're told to do, we're seen as kind of not respecting the frontline workers, or you know, like me traveling outside of my 5 kilometers, which I don't do, isn't going to, I'm not trying to offend the frontline workers, but like there are people really struggling with this, you know?
What difference would it make if it were 10 or 20?
So it's interesting, because there was a study done, and it was because all of our phones are being tracked. I think everyone with Air, I think, it's being tracked by the CSO. I don't know that exactly, but they were trying to gauge what counties.
That's right. I wondered yesterday how they knew that 70% of people went 10K. You're saying it's because of phone tech. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, so it's, yeah, it was the CSO. I think it's just Air. I could be everyone. So they were saying that people who, like you saw that, a third of people are traveling beyond the 5 or 10K. But in Dublin, and I suppose everyone has things nearby, everyone's pretty much staying within the 5 kilometres. And in Roscommon, where there was hardly any cases at all, everyone is leaving their 5, 10K. So it's kind of like...
And I thought we were the rebel county, but we're not. We're overly compliant. But you actually believe that county travel should be reinstated, don't you?
I do. I mean, look, I'm someone who I wouldn't care. I know I feel awful for landlords and pub owners and things like that, but I wouldn't care if a pub didn't open again. You know, it wouldn't bother me. I do miss restaurants. I do miss things like that. But like mentally, I just feel we all need the air. We all need the mountains. You know, we all need fresh air, not just, you know, walking around our, like I live, you know, just outside the city, and I love where I live. But it's not the same mental, it doesn't have the same mental impact, you know, walking around here as getting to the sea. You know, there's people who sea swim. Nobody who sea swims does it because, you know, kind of started it because they have like a great time. Most people sea swim because it brought some form of, you know, mental relief to them, you know.
And in the winter, do you wear a bodysuit?
No. No. Just the swimming dogs.
But it must be Baltic, yeah?
It is, but it's good for you, you know? Putting your body through something tough is good for you. So,
how often?
Yeah. Well, I would have done that at least every Friday, so at least once a week.
And do you feel fantastic after it?
I feel like there's nothing better and like a different human. It's unbelievable. And I really feel for anyone who, my dad said to me once, you know, I said, oh, I don't miss the pubs, I miss the sea, and you know, I don't miss this and I miss that. And my dad said, well, you know, and I thought it was really nice and saying, he said, we all have our sea, you know, and I think everyone has something that gives them that that happiness.
That's
and that,
spot on. Your dad's spot on. That's the one for you. But you didn't go into hypothermic shock or anything.
No.
Ah, you would. I wouldn't be able to do it. I'd get hypothermic shock, wouldn't I?
But you see, you would. You can.
I'm myself convinced that I would. Like.
Yeah. No. You jump in. Not too deep. Like, because you do get taken aback a little bit.
Do you jump in or do you run in?
You're running. Really fast.
And where's your favorite place for that?
A group of us would go to Fountains Down, but not since. We haven't done it. We did it for about a year and a half solid, and then we haven't done it since probably the October lockdown, you know.
So you believe there would be nothing wrong with you doing that in Fountains Town in your own car, drive to it, do your swim and drive home.
Yeah, I firmly believe that. But I just believe, like everyone, as I said there, everyone has their seat. Everyone has something they need. And just locking down to 5 kilometres, it's been proven now that it's not keeping us safe at all. Our urban areas have, you know, a lot of high populated areas, and everyone's going to the same place and it's being spread. And of course,
yeah, but what happens then if you allow people, say, for instance, then go 20 kilometres or whatever, and they go to there's a village nearby and they're in there and they're shopping and they're acting the fool? And yeah,
I know.
You know,
I think it has to be county to county, and I think that would be enough, you know, for
many European countries have curfews, and a lot of other countries then have regionalized lockdowns where an area like with, say, very low numbers would have different restrictions to, as an example, Dublin, you know?
Yeah. Well, I don't know about curfews because in London and stuff, they had everyone getting on the tube at the exact same time and things like that, so it didn't really work in their favour either. But I just think, you know, we just, and I do have to go because I have a meeting now.
Yeah, so do you want me to drive traffic to your change.org petition?
Yeah, that would be fab. And I think we'll get something rolling on that. That'd be fab.
And how can they do that? Change.org, is it under your name or is it under...
It is. And I sent it to Emer. Maybe she can send it on to you because I have people waiting for a meeting for me right now.
You got
now.
It. Off you go. Appreciate it. Thanks a lot. Much obliged. So at the moment, her change.org has only got something like 4 signatures, I think she said.